Oklahoma State will receive the ball. When Missouri got the ball, they missed a field goal two of their first three times. Then they got a touchdown and then a punt and an interception. The touchdown, of course, was by Drain. And Missouri's about to receive the kickoff right now from Oklahoma State. Both quarterbacks, both teams have been able to move the football.
Look at Oklahoma State's possession. Punt, bunt, field goal, punt, TD. And that was on a good drive on their own 20. But Jim, again, you were talking about defense because of the score, 10-7. But both teams have seemed to be able to move the ball into position. Missouri, especially, the first two possessions were in field goal range and missed them.
Victor Moore and Andy Hill are deep. And that's Andy Hill pursuing the kickoff into the end zone. And they'll bring it out to the 20-yard line. And it'll be Marlon Adler, John Redd, Eric Drain in the backfield. They've been using short hose, Hill, McBride, all as their wide receivers. And toward the end of the first half, the freshman David Payton. Tony Davis has been their tight end, but Pat Thetford has played with him and has spelled him. Niptash, Petty, Greenfield, Llewellyn, and Clay, the front four. 10-7 as we begin the second half. Missouri was just absolutely annihilated by Oklahoma last week at 49-7. And they're fighting for pride tonight. Oklahoma State is fighting for the survival rights in the Big Eight, a chance for a Big Bowl. There goes Eric Drain, and Drain picks up about 6 yards across the 25-yard line. O'Neill in on the stop, along with David Webb, number 33. O'Neill 99. Second down and about four. Oklahoma State had an 80-yard drive with Crawford taking it over. Missouri had a 96-yard drive with Drain taking it in. And the difference, of course, is the missed field goals. Missouri has missed both chances. Oklahoma State has made its own. Second down, Adler to his tailback Red, and Red does not have the first down. It'll be third down and 2 or 3 yards. Harding, Ham, Ricky Adams all getting up. Matt Munger also getting up.
Look at the defensive line. Now Hawkins, 69, is the new nose tackle. He's trying to hold up the center. He does a pretty good job at holding up the center, but then you get some people firing in from the outside, and that's James Ham, number 40, that puts the finishing touches on Red. They changed the nose tackle. Remember John Washington, he was getting beaten by Greenfield in the first half of the game. Now they make the change.
Marlon Adler comes up, takes one look, says we want timeout. Came up and Harvey hit the line of scrimmage, looked up, said on third down and short, we want timeout. We'll take timeout. Third quarter, 10-7, Oklahoma State leads. The ball is on the 28th. They've got to get the nose of the ball across the 30-yard line. Adler still with the ball. He can make it on his own and does. He's across the 30 now, pitches it back, and look out. There goes Red, but he stepped out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Red is knocked down and a flag goes down as they really took him in. It looked like Leslie O'Neill just put Red right into the wall.
Jim, I'm going to tell you something. Now take a look what Adler does here. He's going to get the ball out to Red. But I'm going to make a comment on this play now, because it's going to be an unnecessary roughness. Even though Red goes out of bounds, the people are pursuing don't know that. They can't hear the whistles down there as he's going out of bounds. That is a good hit. This is a good hit by Leslie O'Neill, because he is still running with the ball down the sidelines. He does not know that he's out of bounds.
But the officials do, and they flew the flag.
I understand that, because
I know
they know they're blowing the whistle and the thing is out of bounds down here. But
I tell you what, they may not call the penalty. They may say no flag, because
no, they're calling it. They marked it off. They marked it off from the point where you go out of bounds.
Right, but Missouri walked back, and now they've taken the ball down to the 43, and now we will get the call. Unnecessary roughness called against Leslie O'Neill. Now Andy Hill goes wide to the right. Red, this time he hardly gets to the line of scrimmage. Munger stood him up.
All right, Jim. Hawkins is the nose tackle now again in this second half, and he's going up against Greenfield. But Petty comes down, they just chop him. And again, The same thing we talked about in the first half with Washington. He was going that way. They just took him that way.
Ball is on the 41-yard line. Second down and 9 to go. 13 minutes, 7 seconds to go. Third quarter. McBride goes wide right. Adler rolling, throwing on the run, and over there is McBride. And that is a first down inside the 30-yard line at the 28-yard line. Both teams moving the football, although there's very few scores on the board.
McBride was open for a long, long period of time. Adler rolled out, faked a play action pass, bootlegged out to his right side. McBride goes down and ran an out move. And Adler didn't get the grip on the ball right away. And by the time he got set, McBride was still wide open, so he let him have it.
He is now this transfer from the University of Tennessee out wide to the left. First down, Missouri. Adler, the fake to the fullback, and in trouble, gets the ball away. It is caught by McBride, and he is put down. Mark Moore put him down, but that's another first down inside the 15-yard line.
Now look at the room McBride has. They're playing zone here. All right, Rod Brown lets him go. He's in the middle of the zone. He's behind the linebackers and in front of the safety men. And all of a sudden, here comes Mark Moore, who is the corner man on the right-hand side of the field, following him across, but about 8 yards behind him. And they pick up another first down.
And Adler did a good job. He was being harassed as he delivered that ball on the dead run. Adler this time to Red. Red goes against those deep linebackers, gets inside the 10 down to about the 8-yard line. Second down and about 4 to go. Matt Munger, David Webb in on the stop. John Red, a sophomore out of Mayfield, Kentucky. And the man has been catching the ball, McBride, is out of Zanesville, Ohio. Red has come out, Short Horse has come out, and they put in McBride and Hill with one setback. And two tight ends. And that is Drain, not going anywhere at all, is he? You want to tangle him along with us. You can see James Hamm there, but he didn't make the stop. You can see Munger there, and it looked like Leslie O'Neill was the man who got the arm in there.
Bad choice of direction. I don't think I'd want to run at Leslie O'Neill. If you're going to run, I'd go back the other way, because number one, you have Big John Clay over there. Llewellyn is over there, and they're blocking on Harding and Hamm.
Brad has come out. Short Hose has come in. This is third down and 3. All on the 7-yard line. Still the one back offense. And Adler's going to follow him, and Adler's going to get the first down and more. Touchdown! Adler has his 6th touchdown rushing the football. And Missouri goes back in. Green is doing a dance on his knees. He's so happy at the 6-yard line after throwing a big block.
He does throw big blocks. Now just take a look on the outside. They're going to get James Hamm caught, and when he's tied up by Tedford, number 85, the tight end. Look at Adler into the end zone for a touchdown. Leslie O'Neill couldn't get out to the outside. Drain did get an excellent block. When I say an excellent block, he got to the feet of Leslie O'Neill. The man you're talking about, James Hamm, number 40, he couldn't get out because Tedford, the tight end, number 85, did a great job on him.
Well, it is Burdett. They try to make it 14-10. All the bowl scouts are not watching Missouri, they're watching Oklahoma State, and it is blocked. It is blocked by Leslie O'Neill. And so it is 13-10, and Oklahoma State, with a lot of time to go, is within a field goal, trailing by 3.
Leslie O'Neill, Jim, can't do it all by himself, but he does this. He blocks the extra point. Now watch the big man. He comes right up the middle between the center and the guard, and he's right in your face. He blocked it.
Bob Wellahan will kick the ball off, and Bobby Riley is the deep man. And with 4 minutes and 15 seconds gone, this will be the first chance for Oklahoma State to get their hands on the ball. And now the ball goes through and out of the end zone. We'll come out to the 20-yard line. First and 10, and Rusty Hilger and company come back on. But the touchdown
run by Adler has put Oklahoma State behind.
And there is the run, but the good block is right there on the right of your screen at the bottom is Tedford on number 40, Ham, and keeps the linebacker to the inside. If the linebacker can't get there, you can't make the tackle. Mark Moore was too far off. Adler touchdown.
Herman Thomas and Will Timmons are your running backs behind Hilger. And remember, Lewis and Harris and Riley and Weimer all alternate as the wide receivers. And there is Thomas. Trying to get outside and does get outside for 6 or 7 yards. Before he is knocked down there by Justice, number 94, and Snowden, number 40. But it's second down and 4. Absolutely blustery day today across Oklahoma and in Stillwater, but the winds have died. The temperature is dipping toward the 30s at this moment. Two wide receivers to the left on second and short. Fake to the fullback. They throw out, and that is Jamie Harris again. And Harris has got the first down at the 35. How many times would you take the fake to the Oklahoma State fullback? They hardly carry the ball at all, except maybe off the field after a touchdown by somebody else. And Harris is limping. Look what he's done. 6 receptions, 104 yards, may have a cramp.
He twisted his ankle.
Did he?
He twisted his ankle when he made the turn when he slipped and fell, but that's a great play when you have two receivers out there. Now they got one in motion.
That's Riley who's replaced Harris, who's in motion. And this is Thomas again, and he is in a bundle of people there, struggles for yardage and picks up 5. A little freshman out of Missouri City, Texas, does a good job with Bo Sherrill having him about the ankles.
Well, let's just take a look at the blocking up there. But Thomas, when he's running, here's the blocking in a line, and there's a lot of meat on meat up there. But when you see Thomas come through, watch his leg drive. His legs never stop. The continuous effort is just amazing.
Second down at about 5. 9:25 to go, third quarter. Hilger across the middle to his tight end, Hannah. And Hannah looked as though he had the first down before they made the tackle. By Mack.
He's got it.
Let us tell you something about Thurman Thomas. He said he's a freshman out of Missouri City, Texas. 5'11", 185. And last year, they called him the best running back to come out of the state of Texas, and he opted for Oklahoma State. Made the parade in USA Today, first team All-America squads. First down at the 45-yard line for Oklahoma State, trying to recapture the lead and impress the Bull Scouts. They're 7-1, number 7 in the nation. There's Thomas again, and down he goes. And that's a good play by Bo Sherrill again down there. Along with...
Is that running?
Looks like him it is.
Yeah, Runyon.
Steve Runyon, the senior out of Colorado Springs.
I like the game plans offensively for both these teams, really mixing it up well. There was a pass out there to Jamie Harris wide. Then they threw one to the tight end, Hannah in the middle. And they're running left and right. It's just a good game plan.
Two well-coached and drilled ball clubs. Second down and 8. Hilger still got the ball. Fires it over here, and Hannah cannot hold on to it. Takes quite a hit out there from Cameron Riley, the strong safety, and can't hold on to it. Check that. Wallace Snowden is the man who made the hit.
All right, Hannah's going to come across. Now, just take a look at Hilger. He's got enough time to throw the ball. He's waiting for Hannah to clear. Now, he bobbles the ball, but watch Snowden. Bang. And when you hit him like that, when they're bobbling the ball, no way to hold on. That's good defense.
Third down and 8 to go. Riley goes to the left, and Weimer comes to the right. Ball number 47 of Oklahoma State. And they give it to Thomas. And Thomas has got the first down. Thomas has got the first down. Hanging on for dear life was Eric McMillan, Tracy Mack, and Wallace Snowden. But he just broke a few tackles and moves the ball to the 42-yard line.
Roll-out draw play. And it's a beautiful play because you have to have confidence in Partita, the guard. You've got Burton pulling out number 66. Number 76 is also there, Shanklin. And when you have confidence in your offensive line, you can run plays like this. It's just a rollout draw back to the weak side.
13-10 Missouri, Oklahoma State driving. And Hilger still got the ball, has the time, and fires for Riley. And Riley's got the first down inside the 25-yard line. Stop made down there by Pat Day, the freshman at the Cardinals.
Jim Partita, number 50, gets a great block on Staples, number 61 against Missouri. Just take a look at, watch 60 come out. or 50, Partee to come out. Look at the block he gets on Staples right there, puts him on the ground, and that gives Hilger a chance to find his open receiver. That's good play by the offensive line.
That burns 97, replaces Runyon 92 in the defensive line for Missouri. First down inside the 25, Thomas carrying the football. Thomas has got some good moves and gets down to the 15-yard line. He's got this team riled up, and no wonder Mack and Cheryl make the stop.
All right, now the fullback, we know that he doesn't carry the ball that much, but watch how he blocks. Here comes Timmons. He's going to block on the linebacker. He's right there, gets his block, and I can't see the man he's blocking for. Now Thomas breaks it to the outside, but he breaks off of that block.
Second down,
Tracy Mack.
Second down and short to go from just inside the 15-yard line. These teams get the ball and just simply drive the length of the field. Here's Thomas again, and Thomas is dragged down for the first down. Dragged forward by Burns, who just came into the ball game for Runyon. And that's first down at almost the 10-yard line. Pat Jones, his team is 7-1-0, 3-1 in the Big 8. In the chase behind Nebraska, which is undefeated in the Big 8. Weimer wide to the left. Riley comes to the right.
Look at Weimer. Weimer's out there one-on-one on Ray. There it is. Bang. Knocked down.
Knocked down on the line of scrimmage. It was apparent to you, apparent to me, and I think the 11 men in the black and white and gold out on the field.
Yeah, he was going to throw to Weimer, number 22, the split end, sitting on the outside. Pat Ray was there. But this ball is knocked down. All right, take a look. He's looking to his left, and that's where he's going to throw the ball. And here comes the big hands are up.
I couldn't see who it was. Could have been Justice. He's the man on that side, the big tight end, the big defensive end. Second down and 10. And they're going to give it back to the bread and butter freshman. And down all the way to the 5 goes Thurman Thomas. And hanging on to him is Linson Staples, the defensive end. And the flag goes down after the play.
Well, I know Paul Blair, number 72, is missing a helmet.
We're looking on with you because Lauterbach is now going to say sportsmanlike conduct against Missouri. That will move the ball down inside the 5-yard line and give them a first down. And put Oklahoma State with 6 minutes 32 seconds to go in the third quarter in a perfect spot to move ahead again. You keep wondering about that missed extra point. Because if Oklahoma State moves ahead, they'd be ahead by 4. Field goals don't do that much good, but we've got a lot of time left, better than 21 minutes to go. Now put the ball inside the 3-yard line, and it's first down, Oklahoma State trailing by 3.
Mistakes. Penalties are, to me, are stupid mistakes. Now that time, we got an unsportsmanlike conduct against Missouri. They would have had, it would have been 3rd down and 5 with the ball on the 5. Now it's 1st and 10 inside the 3.
Riley in motion. And Thomas with the ball, and he started to go up. And by going up, he may have gotten back to the line of scrimmage. Missouri had that stuffed.
Now you talk about short hands when a guy doesn't reach for the ball. This is called short legs when they cut your legs out before you get ready to stop. Here comes the defense. They're into the flow. Look at, he's just getting ready to go up, and his feet were cut out from underneath him. Had no place to go. Here they come to the inside. And the play is made right in the line of scrimmage. The defensive line, they got about 6 inches on that play.
They got the power eye again with Ken Zachary in, and he's got the football now. And Zachary does not get it. It is 3rd down and goal to go. But this ball is down at about the 1. Vest Weber and Ray made the stop. Vest Weber, a sophomore, is in for Bo Sherrill, the linebacker.
All right, Vest Weber makes a stop, but Pat Ray, number 23, is the man that messes up the play. Now watch it. He's stringing it out to the outside. No chance to get a block. And when you make plays like that, even though you don't make the tackle, Jim, all you have to do is cut him back into your pursuit of your defense.
3rd down, power eye. Hilger calls signals. Is he going to dive? Yes, he's going to dive, and Thomas has a touchdown. And Oklahoma State goes up top. Another long drive.
know, when you see a guy like Thomas go over the top, the guy you have to give credit to is Timmons, number 31, the fullback, because he's got to run in there and block and stick his head in, and there goes Thomas over the top for the touchdown. But the guys that are taking punishment are the fullbacks that are going up into the hole.
All right, Roach adds the extra point. And Thurman Thomas now has his fourth touchdown rushing.
Here he comes, up over the top. That's the same one he scored on before.
Maybe fourth down rushing, his first flying, perhaps. Larry Roach to kick the ball off. And Victor Moore is on your right. Andy Hill is on your left. And this is Andy Hill deep in the end zone, and he will not bring it up. It is first and 10 from the 20.
All right, we're going to watch Thomas go over the top again. You and I scored these two nines, I think, for this dive, which is beautiful. Look at that. Nice form. The only reason we didn't give him a 10 because his feet were not together when he landed.
The crowd here now, after its Oklahoma defense, which after all is fourth in total defense in the nation, but Missouri's moved the ball very well tonight. And are trailing at the moment 17-13. Adler on the quick hand off the plane, and he gets nowhere. Ricky Adams stuffed him.
What a shot by Adams. Now I'm going to talk about a linebacker filling a hole. This is how it's done, folks. Watch this. Bang. There's no place to go.
Short hose comes in. They threw to him effectively early in the ball game, and not too much since. Davis and Thetford have done much of the catching, and they're the tight ends, along with McBride, who is a wide receiver. Three wide receivers out now. Adler gets the ball off to Drain, and Drain gets the ball across the 25. It'll be third down and four. Matt Munger in on the tackle, as you can see, along with Rodney Harding.
Rodney Harding, but watch the power in Drain. He is having probably his best game this year. Watch Drain. Now that's Harding hanging on, but he takes Harding. And is that face mask there?
I think so. It was said that scouts from seven different bowl games are here tonight watching Oklahoma State. Third down and four. Adler, look at all the room, and Red's got over here. He's got the first down, and Moore slows him up at the 45. He's put down at the 49 by Hines. That whole right side of the defense of Oklahoma State was in toward the middle.
You bet. You can't get caught to the inside. The linebackers are at fault there, and also Rod Brown, number 27. Look at the fake is up the middle to Drain. That holds people. Watch this. There's the fake to Drain. Now watch on the outside. You see Rod Brown, 27? He is a safety man. He should have been outside on Red. Now you got McBride blocking downfield on Mark Moore. Mark Moore gets rid of the block and makes the tackle, and I'll save the touchdown.
3:25 to go, third quarter. There's the score, 17-13. Ball is at the 48-yard line. Adler pitch back to Red again. That's Matt Munger going over there, but that's still about 3 yards for Red, and they move into Oklahoma State territory.
Watch Munger. Look at how close he is. Now he's got himself in a position where he can go left and right. Gets away from the blocker, stringing it out. He knows he's got help on the inside by Thompson, 91. Munger makes the play, but they still picked up 3 yards, and there's a player hurt. Who is that?
That's Red, I'm afraid.
Look at the yardage. 78.
John Red comes out, apparently not that bad, although he's holding his hand. And so Manny Henry, 35, a junior of Evanston, Illinois, will go in. Warren Powers, after his team got bashed last week by Oklahoma 49-7, has brought his team back tonight. Powers has never had a losing season, and this is his eighth year as a head coach. He could have won this year, his first ever. He's been National Coach of the Year, last year's Big Eight Coach of the Year, and he's got his team back in playing football tonight.
Yes, he
does. What happened to him last week?
One other comment I'll make on that after this play.
Second down and eight. Adler flips it out, and that is Henry, and he's going nowhere. Rodney Harding was sitting over there along with Harry Roberts just waiting for him.
Jim, the one other thing I was going to talk about, and we talked about at the beginning of the show, out of the five losses that Missouri has, now one they got blown out, no question about that. But the other four, they had the ball and were in striking range of scoring, and they could have won the ball games. And that's the one thing about this game. It may be the last one that has the ball wins this football game.
17-13, but another big third down play. Last time they went Redding around in for the first down, but he's not in there now. Three wide receivers are. Adler has his man on the sidelines, and is it enough?
No.
Is it enough? Hudson makes the stop over there of Tony Davis, the tight end. And if it's not enough, it's, well, about what, half a yard?
Yeah, about almost a yard, but I'll tell you one. You're only won three games, lost five.
Go
for it. Why not? I mean, you have nothing to lose. You got a chance of knocking the sixth-ranked team out of that box, and they're going to run it. They're coming in. Henry's coming in.
More than one.
Deptford's coming in, the other tight end.
Fans love this. Their team is number four in the nation on defense. Fourth down one, a chance to stop and take the ball away at their own 42.
Go right.
And there's Henry, and he's got the first down. Manny Henry, the junior, who just came in for the injured John Redd, gets the first down.
All right, Petty Neptish, they're going to the left-hand side. I was going to say go right, but just take a look at the blocking. Now, Petty, he gets an excellent block on Leslie O'Neill. Got head up with him and then turned him to the outside. Now, watch Henry. The block is to the left. No chance for O'Neill to get there. Henry gets the first down. I like the call. Exciting.
They're putting some tape on the right wrist or hand of Red down below us, and I would assume he'll be back in.
Got official timeout here. Wait a minute, what are they doing? Moving the sticks or something?
I don't know.
They're not calling timeout. They're just getting everything straightened out here.
Now they're ready.
Here comes Dream. He looks like he's limping a little. No, he wanted to come out. They're going to send him back. Get back in there. He's all right.
Well, they still haven't started the clock. Yes, they have. Now the clock has started. With 16 seconds to go. Look what Arizona's doing to Stanford in the third quarter. First down. Ball is just over the 40-yard line. Adler, there's Drain. It's a good thing he went back in there. Ball, he picks up 8 or 9 yards. Good night. David Webb is the man, along with Adam Hines, to make the stop. Check that. Harry Roberts and Adam Hines.
Jim, once you wipe out the nose tackle, now take a look at it. Now Washington's back in. Do you see how far he went? There's Munger, number 90. He misses the tackle, along with Adams missing the tackle. I like to see that again, because all of a sudden Washington disappeared.
Second down, a couple of yards to go. Harry Roberts returned the kickoff in this game last year down at Columbia for a touchdown against Missouri. Second down and short. There's Manny Henry, and Leslie O'Neill is riding him, but he's very close to the first down.
He's going to be short about 4 inches.
Well, we have come to the end of the third quarter. It is Oklahoma State 17, Missouri 13, and Missouri is driving with the football in Oklahoma State territory. We begin the fourth quarter. I'm Jim Simpson, Paul McGuire, Stillwater, Oklahoma. Third down one for Missouri, trailing 17-13. Eric Grain took himself out. Looked like he had an upset stomach on the sidelines. Barbosa has replaced him, and Manny Henry remains the tailback. And Adler has the first down inside the 30-yard line. I may be premature, but I think he's got it.
Yeah, he's got it. You know, we were talking about Washington before. When you take a side as a nose tackle, watch what Greenfield does. See, 80 Washington, when he takes a side, Greenfield just takes him down the line of scrimmage, and it opens up about a five-yard hole in the middle. The linebacker's playing off 5 yards. It's tough to fill.
McBride is wide to the left. Drain is gaining 65 yards thus far tonight. And now here is Henry again, and Henry gets down to the 25-yard line. Second down and six to go. James Hamm makes the stop. But Drain is moving back and forth. As we said, John Redd, it looked as though they're taping his right wrist or hand. In any event, that means that both Redd, the tailback, and Drain, the fullback, neither of the starters are in the ball game on this Missouri drive.
Okay. What do we got? We got a 17-13 game. Look at those stats. 259. And now Oklahoma State passing, they've picked it up a little bit.
Missouri's already gained more against Oklahoma State than what Oklahoma State usually averages. There's Henry following a block, trying to get outside. Leslie O'Neill pursues him out there, makes the stop at the 19-yard line. It'll be third down and short again. And I'm looking down and to see if I can see Drain or Red along the sideline. Here comes Drain back in along with Thetford. And out comes Andy Hill. So they put in a tight end. Drain is back in. Barbosa comes out.
We got another.
Red. He wanted to go in.
Yeah, we got another injured player. And that's Henry.
That is Henry, so Red better be ready. 13:46 to go in the ball game. Missouri driving, but Oklahoma State leading by four. Tonight's game from Stillwater brought to you by Chevrolet, who invite you to see today's Chevy, drive today's Chevy, live today's Chevy. 17-13 Oklahoma State, Missouri with the ball. Henry had to come out. It is third down and a yard at the 20-yard line.
One back, Green.
One back. Red did not come in. Only Eric Green there. Last time, remember, Adler took the ball.
Go left. Look at the hole left.
Look at the hole right. Big splits in the line there. And Green goes down and may have the first down.
No. He's got it.
From the nose tackle to each tackle was 3 or 4 yards. I'm not quite sure what the splits were, but a big wide split in that defensive line of Oklahoma State.
All right, if we could take a look at it from the end zone. Now look at the splits. You see the guards are not covered. They're covered by linebackers who are off 5 yards. When they do that, the linebackers have to fill. Here comes Drain up over the top. Munger has got to come from his right to his left. All right, now watch. The man that's going to make the play is the linebacker who plays on the right-hand side of the defense, left of the offense. Munger, he comes in to help out on the play, but that's a long way to go for that linebacker because, as you said, Jim, the splits are there, and they're almost 4 yards.
Ball is at the 19. It is a first down. They're still going with the one back offense. Hill wide to the left. The freshman David Payton, number 86, is in. He is to the right. And Thetford and Davis are both in. Here's Adler. They fake the drain. Adler trying to get outside. Adler gets a yard maybe, and that's all down to the 18-yard line. Adam Hines, number 14, pursuing him clear across the field.
I can promise you one thing, my friend. When Adler was not faking the drain because he's the only back in there. There's no one to pitch to, and Adler had to eat the ball. Take a look at it. Here comes Adler down the line. I think he wanted to give it to Drain, but he saw the force in the backfield. When he saw that, he said, I got to get out of bounds, and now.
Short hoser leading receiver is not in there. Red, their leading runner tonight, is not in there. Drain is in there. Second down and long.
Tight end.
Oh, Adler throwing for Davis, and the ball is almost intercepted. Davis was down the sidelines in double coverage, and Yancey almost had a chance to come up with it, and I thought he had.
Boy, Yancey made a great play as the cornerback because what Yancey does, you don't see him in the screen right now. What Yancey does, he looked like Davis had a free spot to go. Gave it to him and then took it away, then Yancey dropped back deep. That was a perfect play. Hines was also back there, but the corner man, Yancey, I liked it.
Burdick, we understand that Manny Henry has a sprained knee and will not be back. We don't know about the condition of Red with that hand. They need it here or try for another field goal, and Adler's in trouble, gets out of trouble, in trouble, down he goes, they'll have to go for the field goal. And they missed two already tonight. Had they not missed two, they would be ahead.
Munger was the man that was blitzing, the linebacker, and he had a shot at Adler and missed him, and Adler got back to the outside, but he didn't pick up the first down. Watch 90. Here he comes. Right there. He delayed on the blitz. Munger misses the play. Adler moves back to the outside. Harding saves because it could have been a touchdown.
This one will be of 34 yards. Burdett has missed 38 and 43 yards tonight.
This one on the left, the one on the right. This one should be down the middle. Oh, blocked.
And that's blocked. That looks like O'Neill again that did it.
It was.
O'Neill blocked an extra point and now blocks the field goal attempt. Oklahoma State got the ball near midfield. Beautiful defensive play.
Watch Leslie O'Neill, Jim. No one, it looks like they don't even touch him. The line play is not made. Petty, is he the one that misses? No, the center missed him. And here comes Leslie O'Neill up the middle, and that big body took the blow. That's a great play. That's an extra point and a field goal.
Well, they have missed now on three field goals, one of which has been blocked. They missed on an extra point, but with the kicking game, they've missed a total of 10 points. and they trail 17-13. Now they pick up a flag that was thrown, and they'll come back the other way and move it into Missouri territory.
Well,
15 was, big ones.
Lenson Staples, number 61, saying something to the official. That's unsportsmanlike conduct, I think.
Personal foul.
Is it fun being a kicker? Look at Burdick. Now, once he kicks the ball.
That was Willahan, not Burdick.
Oh, that's Willahan. Okay, I'm sorry, Jim.
That's my fault.
Just take a look at him. Once he does, not only does Leslie O'Neill block it, but he also knocks the kicker down.
Well, they took the job away from Burdick on that 34-yard try and gave it to Tom Willahan, and he is the one that had a block. But you can't fault him because O'Neill was free and running. Now put the ball at the 36, and Oklahoma State up by 4. 12 minutes to go. There's a flea flicker play, and they're going for Jamie Harris in the end zone. Touchdown!
Jim, what a beautiful play. Rusty Holder just, I mean, he laid this ball out for Jamie Harris. Jamie Harris runs right by Pat Ray. They had no chance. It was just super, and he laid the ball right on the money.
Welch comes on to add the extra point. And all of a sudden, it is 24-13. Remember, all those bowl scouts are looking on, and now they're looking at something.
All right, just take a look at it. There's Thomas. He throws it back to Holder, and just watch where he puts the ball. Jamie Harris, all he has to do is wait for it in the end zone because there's no chance for Pat Ray, 23, to get there. Makes the catch, touchdown. That's pretty.
12 minutes to go, but now it is a long way back for the University of Missouri. Larry Roach will kick it off. And this is Hill at the 8. To the 20 and to about the 23-yard line. What is first down and 10 to go from there. But what a beautiful job done by the defense again of Oklahoma State.
Yes, they did. That blocked field goal sets it up. All right, here's Thomas back to Holder, and then Jamie Harris just outruns Pat Ray downfield. Pat Ray's only job is to stay with that wide receiver.
Paul, you know that we've been saying that Oklahoma State has been scoring 4.5 points per game. They have not scored here, but a Ricky Adams interception set up a 3-point field goal, and then the blocked field goal attempt set up the flea flicker play for another 10 points.
And a block extra point.
And a block extra point because Adler in deep trouble. Deep trouble. Matt Munger, John Washington, got to him. He has been moved about a little bit in the center tonight, but that time he took dead aim on Adler.
All right, you see Washington. He's going outside, and he's got some time. He gets around Petty, and when he does, take a shot at Adler right there. The defense now is fired up. Now they can afford to blitz. They know that Missouri has to throw the football.
Second down and 25. Oklahoma State beginning to take charge now. Adler tries to get him out and fires the ball. It is incomplete, intended for the freshman, David Payton. That ball was thrown hard and around his ankle. Oklahoma State looking to go up 8-1 and avoid what happened to Texas, Washington, Iowa, Miami, Florida State, and West Virginia today. Those teams I just named all lost today.
Jim, you know, a guy like Leslie O'Neill, number 99, you just can't say enough about him. He will be an All-American. There's no question about it. He's a big, strong guy, very quiet man, but he can turn a ball game around. The blocked extra point was important. Then all of a sudden, the blocked field goal.
There's Adler on third and 25, sacked again. Oh, he gets away. Another time he gets away, but can't get away now and must go out of bounds. And it's fourth down and 23. And they'll have to kick the ball. Back to Oklahoma State.
Adler is running for his life. Here comes Munger now. Matt Munger. Now take a look at him. He goes out. He's got a shot at Adler. Misses him in the backfield. Now watch Munger. You think he quits? He was on the ground. Trying to get a little wind, too.
Bobby Riley's the deep man. Willahan standing on his own yard line. They got 10 men coming. And that's An effective kick away from Riley and gets a bounce straight off to the left and out of bounds inside the 40-yard line. 10:52 to go. It's 24-13 Oklahoma State. Sunday evening at 7 o'clock Eastern time, the final round of the Kapalua International Championship from beautiful Kapalua, Maui, Hawaii. Sandy Lyle leads by three shots at the moment, a 12 under par over Greg Statler. Andy Bean is 7 under, Lee Trevino 6 under, as has been Hard Langer. But Lyle's got the three-shot lead on the field. First down, Oklahoma State, which had an 11-point lead here tonight over Missouri. Georgia throwing with the 11-point lead and has Weimer out here, and Weimer has got the first down and is knocked out of bounds. Knocked out of bounds by Cameron Riley at the 46-yard line.
Jim, you're talking about surprising throwing, yeah, with that lead. But take a look at Weimer. He's playing up. Pat Ray, number 23, is playing so far off him. Hildier just sees it out there. Watch Weimer. And then Ray comes out. Watch, he just comes into the picture. You've got to get yourself under control and make the tackle. He does not do that. Weimer gets out and picks up another 7 or 8 yards.
Jamie Harris wide to the right. And, oh, look at this play. That is Steve Runyon all over Thurman Thomas in the backfield. Runyon just got loose.
Now, the only thing when I look at this game defensively, Missouri, I said they had to stay in this game defensively. We're moving the ball offensively. You think about something. Miami today, they were ahead 31-0 at the halftime and lost the game to Maryland 42-40.
With Maryland down on the 1 foot line as the game ended, just running out the clock. Second down, amazing performance. And over the middle to Hannah, the tight end. And he draws a crowd led by Bo Sherrill and Tracy Mack, the two inside linebackers. Well, I wonder what the Bowl Scouts are thinking today about Oklahoma State, about all of those teams that have lost. Can't make any formal bids until what, the 24th, 2 weeks from today? And how about Georgia? The Bulldog fans must be upset. They were really obliterated by Florida today. Third down and about three to go. And over here for the catch is Malcolm Lewis, number 8. On him is Matichak, but that's a first down inside of 35.
Jim, they had a corner blitz on that time. And when they ran the corner blitz, Matichak was supposed to come up on Lewis and did not. He left Lewis out there by himself. Excuse me, that was a great play by Rusty Hildier because he read it, saw the safety off, threw the ball out to Lewis, first down.
Missouri needs but two scores to get ahead, but the way Oklahoma State has begun to play offensively and defensively, that is a tall order indeed. Thomas trying to get some running room and is dragged out of bounds by Gary Justice. 9:14 left in this 24-13 ball game. And the big plays, and they happen in a hurry. O'Neill, who has a sack and has blocked a conversion point, blocked a field goal attempt on the first play, flea flicker play. Hildier handed to Thomas. Thomas flicked back to Hildier, who laid it right on the money to Jamie Harris for the long touchdown. Second down and 7. Ball on the 30-yard line. Hildier with time, throwing, and look at this. The ball is up for grabs and almost intercepted. Walt Snowden put a big hit on Bobby Riley. And Riley could not hang on to the ball.
Jim, it was a big hit, but Snowden went for the man, almost let him catch it. Look at Hildier now. He's got protection in the backfield. Timmons gets a good block. The throw is there. Now it's down here to Riley, but watch Snowden. He's not really looking at the ball. He's looking at the man. And what's that ball was in his hands. Now that was questionable because Riley took maybe one or two steps. It might have been a fumble, but what a great hit.
Third down and still 7 to go.
Corner blitz, he's got to get up.
Wow, did he take a hit, but the ball is caught by Weimer. Not enough for the first down. Matichak put him down. Hildier really took a hit as he delivered the ball.
Hildier does take a shot, but they had a full-scale blitz on him with the corner coming in. And that's Tracy Mack, number 36. Well, he kind of just pushed him. It wasn't that big a deal. He might have hurt himself by falling down. Are they going to? They are going to go for it here. The crowd loves it. Fourth and one.
You were right about that. The crowd absolutely adores it.
Yeah, but now they're going to take time out. Let's talk about this.
Yes, with 8:32 to go, it's 24-13 Oklahoma State. And they have taken timeout and will talk over whether or not to go for it or try for the field goal. A reminder, Paul and I'll be picking the Chevrolet players of the game, and of course we'll pick one player from each team on behalf of Chevrolet. And Oklahoma State of Missouri will receive $1,000 each for its general scholarship fund in the name of those two players that we name. Well, looks like they are going for it. Thurman Thomas is in there. And it is fourth down and a yard, and they're using the power eye with Ken Zachary as the man to the right side.
I wonder what they're going to call.
A little dive. You think so?
No.
Tilger looking out here and throwing out here, and the ball is caught out here by Dillard, the freshman tight end. First and goal to go.
Jim, I'm going to tell you, what a great call. They fake that dive play. Hilger goes back. He's going to throw it to Dillard out here. Take a look. Isn't that a nice play? That's beautiful.
And that was over Jeff Hooper, who has just been put in for Pat Ray on the right corner. Look at this. Here goes Thomas. And they say he did not get it. Oklahoma State really trying to turn it on now. Remember, this ball game at the half was 10-7 Oklahoma State. And then it was 17-13 at the end of three quarters.
Everybody likes to dive in the air, I see. But that's a little far from the three-yard line out, isn't it?
Matt Jones, well, he's got Iowa State next week. Iowa State tied Kansas State today in frigid weather when Kansas State thought they had a field goal to win it at the end, and then they got to go to Oklahoma on the 24th. So bowls or big bowls await Oklahoma State. And now there goes Thurman Thomas. His second touchdown of the night, his fifth of the year. And that puts it out of reach of Missouri.
I mean, there's just no way to stop it. You've got Timmons out in front blocking again, and I give a lot of credit to the fullback and the offensive line blocking, but we just watch Thomas go up over the top. Once he sees that hole, all he has to do is leave his feet. Bang, touchdown.
And now Roach. And now the ball game is Oklahoma State, one of their best starts ever in the last, well, 40 years.
Here he goes again. I love this jump. Thomas, he just turns his back. And look at how far in the end zone he is. He ends up 4 yards there. There he comes. Look at Timmons up front. He's got to go in, and he just hits on Bo Sherrill, number 49. Opens it up.
7:34 to go. The moon is shining on the Cowboys, not on the Tigers tonight. It is 31-13 as Larry Roach will kick off. You can see the first three possessions, touchdown, touchdown, touchdown for the Cowboys, and they've broken the game open here in the second half. Hill is the deep man at the two and gets across the 20-yard line. Well, next week we have a doubleheader coming up for you here on ESPN at noon Eastern time. Penn State and Notre Dame. Penn State, they say, if they beat Notre Dame on the way to a bowl, that's what we hear. Neither of those teams play today. Georgia played today. I would just like to forget what happened with Florida today up in Jacksonville. They really got shut out and beaten. And Auburn had an easy time. Bo Jackson will line up, what was it, 60-0 over Cincinnati? That's our game. Paul and I'll be Georgia at Auburn next Saturday night. Down in East Alabama. First and 10 from the 23. There's a fake to Red, who's back in the ball game, and Adler running for his life and putting it up, and the ball is caught. Roberts puts down Tony Davis, the tight end. Well, it looks as though Warren Powers, in his eighth year, is going to have his first losing season ever. If he loses tonight, he'll be 3-6-1 and just a game left.
Jim, we saw George Shorthose catch three passes for 80-some yards in the first half. We have not seen Shorthose in the second half. Now, he did have a hip pointer last week in the game, and we're checking on it now to see if that thing is acting up again on him.
7:15 and counting. Bowl scouts have to be impressed by the defense of this Oklahoma State team and how they've taken charge of the
fumble.
Fumble. Drain loses the ball. Aaron Roberts is jumping up and down saying, "We got it," but I don't think he does. They're getting up, and it looks instead as though Llewellyn might have come up with it. Number 64.
Drain is now, he is limping.
They've lost a few people. Barbosa will go out. Drain after the fumble. Barbosa comes in at fullback.
We just heard that George Shorthose, number 46, has re-injured that hip pointer, and he is not back in the game, and we probably will not see him.
That takes away a big part of Missouri's weapons. Second down from the 39, about five. And there's Red, and Red's got the first down. He is a good-looking tailback, a sophomore to Mayfield, Kentucky. Two 100-yard games. Last year, he averaged almost 6 yards a carry, and he came into tonight's game averaging 6 yards a carry. John Red. Ball is at the 47-yard line, but more importantly, the clock continues to run down before this crowd in Stillwater, Oklahoma. Oklahoma State, we told you that next week, Missouri plays Kansas. Oklahoma State gets Iowa State here and then goes to Oklahoma. Oklahoma had a big win today. Adler, that ball was almost intercepted by Harding. Right into the hands of Harding, who has an interception return for a touchdown this year. And is that Adler who is hurt?
Adler is down. Neptish, take a look at him. He's on Leslie O'Neill. And that's holding, folks. That's the only way I can tell you. Leslie O'Neill's going down. Look at Neptish. He's not even going to let him get up. He's just rolling on his back.
Marlon Adler, the walk-on punter who turned into the starting quarterback, is down. By the way, we neglected to say, and we hope that Marlon will be up, certainly, that he's from Winfield, Kansas, and Barry Hanna's been catching passes for the other team. Oklahoma State was a teammate of his in Winfield, Kansas. Playing under the lights here for the first time in more than 50 years, and the lights are provided tonight by Musco. They've been with us quite a few night games where they don't have lights. Musco moves in, puts up lights, and let there be light, and there is. Adler coming out. That should bring on Warren Seitz, number 8, who was the starting quarterback at the beginning of the year. Arizona, 21-7, third quarter in a Pac-10 game. Fullerton State losing to UNLV, but that's early, just by touchdown. New Mexico over the Air Force, 6-3 at the half. How about that? That surprises a lot of folks. Well, Army surprised Air Force last Saturday night. Second down and 10. Seitz is the man at the controls. He is a fine runner, but they need some more than that. That's Harry Roberts that stacks him up there. They need some throwing of the football when you're down 31-13 with less than 6 minutes to go.
How many times you see a quarterback come in like Seitz, number 8, and sitting on the bench, and it's cold down there, believe me, folks, and he's been down there for like 2.5 hours not doing anything. They're going to run the football, but you can't afford to run the football. You've got to put the ball in the air.
5:40 to go.
Either Chad.
Oklahoma State went to the Sugar and Cotton Bowls back in the 40s, and not that much since. But Johnson got him going, and Pat Jones has him there, and Seitz now is in trouble. Now he throws, and that ball was almost picked off first by Hines. He was the first man that had a shot at it, and then the man who wanted it was Rob Brown right behind him.
Okay, Leslie O'Neill, let's take a look at him again. There's Petty on him, and also Niptish is on him. Just take a look, and they're battling, and now Greenfield comes over, and he gets a little piece of him. Seitz outside, and he had his man open downfield. He just overthrew Hines, or overthrew his wide receiver, and Hines almost picked it off.
That is well ahead to kick the ball away to Bobby Riley. Riley, fair catch at the 16 or 17 yard line where it is first and 10 for Oklahoma State. Score 5:18 to go in the game. Cowboys 31, Tigers 13. And Oklahoma State is doing its duty and impressing the Bowl Scouts. Oklahoma State is 7-1-0. They lost to Nebraska 17-3. They were leading 3-0 when Nebraska had a punt return on that put them up 7-3. They went on to beat them 17-3. Other than that, Oklahoma State has just been having a great season, and it continues tonight. Hildreth hands off to the tailback, and that is Thurman Thomas, who's had a good night. And he's snowed under by many people, led by Justice. But the clock becomes Missouri's enemy. And what started out a season of great hopes on the parts of many, despite graduation down in Columbia, Missouri, is winding up not that good for the Missouri Tigers or their coach Warren Powell.
107 yards for Thurman. And I'll tell you, that time he might have been able to break to the outside, but you can bet the coach Pat Jones said to him, look, don't go out of bounds. You got to go up and take the hit inside.
Here's Thomas again. He scored two touchdowns tonight. Gets out near the 20-yard line. That's running down the clock. Well, you just wonder. This is an exciting time of the year when you begin to wonder who's going to what bowl. And after today, who's going to be number one? Washington was. Will Nebraska move up? They were two in the AP poll. What about Brigham Young, undefeated? What about South Carolina? For the first time ever, they've won 9 ball games in a season. Our congratulations to Joe Morrison down there. Third down here for Oklahoma State. And the ball is handed to Thomas, and he does not get the first down. And so they'll have to kick the ball away with about 4 minutes to go. But they ran a lot of time off the clock. So on the one hand, we conjecture about the polls as they come out on Monday. And on the other, we wonder about the bowls, which really won't be formally decided until 2 weeks from today.
You know, we've got to pick the Chevrolet player of the game, Jim. And it's difficult because of Oklahoma State. They've had so many people that did so well in this game.
I got my pick. But we'll defer it for a while.
Cookie.
Fourth down. Cooper to kick the ball away. Remember the kick he got out of the end zone?
How about this one?
Andy Hill back at the 35-yard line and looking for running room, gets across the 40 to the 41. And a flag is down across the field. 3:26 to go. 31-13 Oklahoma State with a flag down. And the referee of the night, J.C. Lauterbach, has the word now to tell us what it is. And it is a clip. So that will cost Missouri even more. Well, let's talk about Top Rank Boxing coming up next Wednesday night at 9 o'clock, live from Resorts International Atlantic City. Adolfo Medel of Sunrise, Florida will go against Freddie Pendleton in a 10-round lightweight match, and then in an 8-rounder junior welterweight, Greg Edelman and Cato Wilson fight one another. One of the most popular series on ESPN, Top Rank Boxing. They'll move back after the clipping penalty. Takes the ball back inside the 25-yard line. Well, Adler has been hurt. Red hurt his hand, but he's coming back in now. Drain was out, apparently upset stomach or something, but he came back to play. Lachey came in after being a non-starter because of a pinched nerve, and apparently he's pulled ligaments in his knee. He is out. All this from Missouri. Barbosa is the fullback. And they're running the ball, giving the ball to Red. And I said that with a note of surprise in my voice. Munger made the stop, but that runs time off the clock.
I was surprised. Red's got 93 yards.
Adler is your throwing quarterback, but Seitz started out. He is an outstanding runner himself, but they're still running the football. Being down by 18 points as the clock clicks below the 3-minute mark. Second down and about 3. Here's Seitz. This time he's going to throw. He can find somebody and does find somebody, and that's Red coming out of the backfield. And Ricky Adams has an interception tonight and an outstanding hit on Drain coming through the line of scrimmage, makes the stop. But that's a first down for Missouri.
You think Leslie O'Neill thinks that this game is in hand? Just take a look what he did with Niptesh there.
Whoops.
He just grabs him and throws him on the ground. He's hustling. He's getting to the quarterback. A big man can move. He is so quick.
Well, he runs about a 4.740 for a man 235 pounds. Has his 8th sack tonight. Here's Seitz back again. Look out. In trouble. Down he goes.
You know what it is, don't you?
Who is it?
Leslie.
Leslie.
O'Neill again is just shedding his blockers. That is playing much of the night in the Missouri backfield.
Yes, he is. He just Niptesh again. He just throws him away. Is he out there blocking out? Yeah, that's right. Watch this. Goodbye. You're gone. I'll get away from the Barbosa, who number 22 is the fullback. That's two guys he went through and then got to the quarterback. Hello.
Ball is inside the 40-yard line on the Missouri side of the 40, and it is second down and about 15 yards to go. as McBride goes out wide to the left. Payton comes out to the right, and Hill is flanked inside him, and Seitz is back to throw. Second and 15, look out from behind. He gets the ball away. That is Andy Hill, and Hill is dragged down by Hines. But that's the first down at the 39-yard line. We'll stop the clock to move the sticks with 1:44 left.
You were saying, we're not just laying on this forever, but when you were saying look out from behind, Seitz, it was Leslie O'Neill again. He was coming back. He almost had time to get there, but it was a good throw by Seitz and a nice catch by Hill.
Well, a lot of games today, as we've already reported, and the Chevrolet football scoreboard will report to you, have gone the way most people didn't think they'd go. A lot of big upsets today, but this will not be one of them. Moore is wide to the left. Victor Moore. Seitz steps up, delivers the ball. And that is Tony Davis again. He's had a good night, but that is not enough for the first down. Harding puts him down, but the clock is going to be well below the 1 minute mark before they get another playoff. And now the fans who have seen their Cowboys take charge, especially on defense in the second half, to win their eighth game of the season, are beginning to leave Lewis Stadium here in Stillwater, Oklahoma. Time has been called by Missouri with 56 seconds to go. But Paul, what do you think? When I say what do you think, looking at Oklahoma State with the idea that we're looking at Oklahoma State with the same eyes that at least seven different bowl scouts are looking here, and realizing that Oklahoma State, by combination of circumstances, including a win over Oklahoma themselves and Oklahoma beating Nebraska, etc., could have a shot at the Big Eight title and the Biggie down in Miami.
Yeah, well, they've got one big game, really a big game coming up, not Iowa State, but I mean the next one after that. That's going to tell the story for this team, and they are. You know, it took them a while to get adjusted on defense. But, you know, when you have a man like Leslie O'Neill, Jim, that can turn a game around defensively. And you mentioned something before about this team defensively, what they do, right? They've got four interceptions. They've got four interceptions for touchdowns. They've got four safeties. And they've only thrown, up until this game, four touchdown passes on offense.
And a blocked conversion and field goal tonight, which led to a touchdown. They've been looking at that across the screen there, Georgia and Auburn. That's what Paul and I like to say, that we're going to be there next Saturday night down in eastern Alabama. Auburn has a shot, remember, for the Southeastern Conference title, as does LSU and Florida, which is in the driver's seat. It all starts at 7 o'clock with our college football show.
You know who's back?
Bo Jackson.
And he scored today. Bo Jackson is back for Auburn.
At least he scored. They scored 60 points. I don't know how many Bo Jackson got, but Auburn got 60 against Cincinnati.
We did the game where he got hurt.
At Texas.
You bet. You got your Chevrolet player?
Oh, yeah. But
you got your Oklahoma State. I'll let you have that. I'll do the one for Missouri.
Okay. Second down and short yardage to go, but the game is out of hand and belongs to Oklahoma State. And Missouri's going to go home losers again. They lost 49-7 to Oklahoma, and the fans are getting on the officials for making them re-huddle down there for some reason or another. We told you about the Chevrolet College Football Report, all of today's upsets in college football and successes in college football, and strange stories such as the Miami-Maryland game. Seitz delivers the ball out here and has McBride. And McBride cannot get out of bounds. Harry Roberts drops off and makes the tackle inside the 25-yard line. But that is the first down and will stop the clock while he moves the sticks.
When are we going to give him? When are we going to give him all excited about?
Well, we've got to wait till the format. We wait till it's all over and give a score, and then we go away and we come back, and then we surprise everybody.
Oh, okay. Okay.
There's Seitz passing over to the sideline on the far side, and Hill cannot hold on to it. Oklahoma State, as we said, has lost only to Nebraska. They've beaten Arizona State. Well, they walloped them, didn't they? San Diego State was a close one. Tulsa was no problem. Then the Nebraska loss. And since then, everything's been coming up. Not necessarily roses, maybe oranges or blue bonnets or something. They've knocked off Kansas and Colorado, an unexpectedly tough game. Kansas State. And tonight they're winning, and they've got Iowa State here next Saturday, and then they go on down to Norman, Oklahoma. Long trip with a big job ahead of them. Bring it out here to Barbosa. Barbosa can't even get out of bounds. That's John Washington out there, and we've got a half a minute to go.
No, that was Munger, number 90.
Sorry.
I'll tell you, Munger was just, I mean, he played off the block. and also made the tackle. Jim, it was just beautiful. This defense is not quit. That's what makes this team 8-1 now after this game is over, because they don't quit. They had a tough time in the first half of the ball game, a very close game. Missouri got the kickoff in the second half, marched the length of the field, scored a touchdown, but this defense never quit.
Munger has already graduated. Munger is a walk-on, an academic All-American who has graduated, is now going for his master's degree here, filling out his collegiate eligibility. But as I said, he's a walk-on to become a leading tackler, and they say just a very, very smart man. Here's the Big Eight standings. Nebraska is the only undefeated team, but you'll see that after tonight, Oklahoma State and Oklahoma will be all flat tied, and they get each other in 2 weeks. But in the meantime, Oklahoma's got Nebraska coming up. Missouri is 2-2-1. As of this moment, game not over. Kansas State thought they had a win today, but settled for a tie. Colorado State and Iowa State, after the way they played Oklahoma, I thought they'd do better in the Big Eight than what they did. Here's Sykes, the young growing team, and Sykes is in trouble, and he's going to get out of. No, he's not going to get out of bounds. Now he's going to get out of bounds with 21 seconds to go.
And number 99 chasing him again.
Well, we've seen good ball games at West Point where it was cold. And here in Stillwater, where it's been cold, and maybe in Auburn next week, they'll warm it up for us.
All right, here's Munger. We talked about him. Look, he's just looking for a place to go.
Look at this.
He took himself out of the play, but you talk about hustling.
Quite a performance by Oklahoma State. They were playing head up, and Missouri was controlling their line of the scrimmage when they had the ball for the first half and part of the third quarter. But then Oklahoma State began to take charge. And that ball is caught down there. Yancey makes the tackle to McBride. And that's the first down with 14 seconds to go, stopping the clock again on the first down. For many years now, Oklahoma State fans have heard about everybody up at Norman. Now they got something to cheer about down here in Stillwater. Sykes is in trouble, and down he goes, and that could be it. 3-2, Pat Jones is out, 1, and it's all over. And Oklahoma State, with bowl scouts in attendance, have won their 8th ball game. They've lost but one. And Warren Powers about to have his first losing season, and Missouri's going to have a losing season. They're now 3-6-1 with only one game to play. And Thurman Thompson scored a couple of touchdowns tonight. Leslie O'Neill, what an outstanding job he did on defense tonight and turned the ball game around. Paul and I will come back, and we've got those Chevrolet players of the game coming up. And we'll make our selection. But look at Pat Jones, the young bachelor, first-year head coach. Oh, yeah, Pat.
Yeah.
That's it. We got it. On to the bowl. But which one?